What's your reading of testing so far?
Always very difficult to judge. I mean, on full tanks yesterday, we didn't look too bad. We're a little bit off on pace. We've got some handling imbalance with the car, which we can fix with a rest. We know what the problem is. We didn't come here with all the bits we wanted. So, but of course, the other teams will be progressing as well. So, I think we are reasonable. Not as quick as Ferrari, and Lewis looked quick yesterday. So it looks like we've got a little bit of work to do.
Are Ferrari as quick as they seem, in your opinion?
It was slightly strange because on full tanks yesterday we were the same pace as they were, but on the lower fuel they were quicker. So, but that may be a factor of the issues we have with the car at the moment. So, but they look pretty good shape. They look in good shape.
Talking about the issues you have with the car, can you shed any further light on those?
We've got an exhaust problem. We're cracking exhausts, and we're having to change exhausts every 150 terminal kilometres. It's a problem we can fix. Of course, here it's difficult, but the rest of the car's good. We've got a handling imbalance because we're all learning about these tyres here, and I think we've seen straight away some things we want to do on the tyres, which we'll have done for a rest.
And of course, you've got two new drivers this season, Nico Rosberg and Michael Schumacher. How are they shaping up for you so far?
Very professional. I mean, they're both excellent drivers. They're consistent in their feedback, both drivers. Michael's obviously breaking himself in again, so he's not driven here as far as I know. So, but very good. You know, we're very excited about the pairing we've got, and they're working well together.
You spoke earlier about how important Michael's feedback was, how precise it was. How significant is that for you as you're looking to develop the performance of the car as we get closer to Bahrain?
Well, very important. Of course, I, having worked with Michael for a long time, I know how to judge his feedback. With Nico, we're learning. Nico's feedback will be equally important, but we need to understand, you know, the magnitude of the comment he makes. Whereas with Michael, you know, I understand completely. If it's something which he wants to make a strong point on, I understand exactly what he's trying to say. It's just normal. With Nico, it's our first test, our first 3 days testing. We're just getting to know each other.
As we get closer to the start of the season, all the teams are testing out their cars and new bits and pieces. We've heard some concerns about another diffuser row brewing.
Right. I don't think it'll be us this year. I'm not aware of that, to be honest. At the moment, we've got our heads down trying to sort out our car, so I don't know very much what's going up and down the pit lane, but I haven't heard of that yet. But let's wait and see.
Are you worried about any of the teams being on the edge of legality again with anything?
Well, we're always on the edge of legality. I mean, all the teams are on the edge of legality. That's how you race. It's just whether, in some people's view, the interpretation you take crosses that edge. And then people don't deliberately cheat. They just take a competitive interpretation of the regulation. So I think that's our business. And if someone's been clever enough to see a way of doing something we haven't, then we'll have to get on to it ourselves. But I'm not anticipating any issues, but we'll wait and see.
And some other things that we know are definitely happening for next season, the rule changes. What's your take on the new system? Are you worried that it might affect the historical statistics? Or
it's a very good point. I mean, you know, the number of points that someone scored in a season or number of points they've scored in their career, that's all it's a new reference now. We can't use those old references. I mean, you won't change the number of wins that somebody made, but of course when you get 25 points for a win, you very quickly escalate the total, perhaps beyond the references we had in the past. So that's a bit of a shame. But, you know, if it improves the racing, if it improves the entertainment, then we should have it. We'll have to wait and see.
Do you think it will make teams more likely to race to win, which is, I think, the idea behind it?
Well, that's the only reason behind it. And there's now a reasonable gap between the first place and second place. So there's a much stronger incentive for second place to try and beat the guy in front. When there's only 2 points, perhaps the argument goes it's not such an incentive. When there's 7 points, it's much more attractive. So I hope so. I think the move to start the race on the tyres you qualify on is a good one. We'll see. The race strategy, we need to wait and see how the cars, how consistent they are, how they use their tyres. But a little bit concerned about how the race strategies will work out.
Just quickly on the point that you mentioned there about tyres, have you heard any more about the idea behind making teams do two stops for tyres?
Well, there was mixed opinion on that. I think the teams feel we should look at where we are. We should see how the racing goes. And if we find that we're not putting on the show we want, we'll have to reconsider. But I think we don't know enough yet to anticipate how the racing is going to be. So I think we need to wait for a few more races before we start changing things such as that.
Okay, and finally, lots and lots of changes. No refuelling, the point system. Everyone looks quite tight so far in testing. Do you think it's going to be another close and exciting season?
I think so. I think it's got some fascinating elements. Obviously, our two new drivers, Fernando at Ferrari, Jensen at McLaren, there's some wonderful, exciting elements. So I think it's going to be a great season.